plays. Handle the rockets at the pig myself. I'm the one that's always up late night. Late night. They were in the back. What is going on, guys? It's your boy Emraz, and today I'm going to be showing you Xur's location. Now, I do realize I'm a little bit late. To be honest, I completely forgot he was coming today. But anyways, you want to spawn in at the tower right around here, and he is located directly down middle. Wow, I kind of like stuttered on that located, like that was really weird. I like to point out my own flaws. Anyways, he's right across from Lord Shax right here, as you can see him. This week's inventory is okay. I'm kind of happy about, I guess, upgrade equipped exotics, maybe, you know, stuff like that. It's also kind of a troll because he is selling the Mito multi-tool. I don't know how many people want it, but I non-stop get this weapon. Like, this is my weapon that I always get, and it's ridiculous. It's a good gun, but I don't use it that often. Anyways, let's start off with the Titans. For the Titans, he has the Ruined Wings at a stat roll of 91 out of 98 strength, so that is, I'm pretty sure, low. I don't know what gauntlets actually go up to, so that might be either mid or really low. I'm not really sure on gauntlets, but I would wait out unless you have a pair already. But I think I'm gonna buy ones because I feel like my Ruined Wings are broken. I know I just told you you would wait, but I feel like mine are broken. I have a higher roll, like a couple higher, but then again, strength doesn't really matter. So either way, I'm going to buy it because I think mine are broken, and I'm going to try them out and see. Now, for the Hunters, he has a Symbiote, and with a Discipline roll of 87 out of 94. Now, that is very low. If you don't have it, I would wait. It's a great helmet though for PvP. I love it. For almost anything else, I actually really like it, except for Crota. You know, I use Master Thurman because that is what's best for it, but it's a great helmet and I would recommend buying it, but not this week. Now, for upgrade equipped exotics, you can see that it's here as well, out of 104. Now, I would say upgrade it instead of buying it this week, because that is a difference, a pretty good difference. So, difference about 10 if you can do the simple math. Anyways, yeah, I would say upgrade it instead of buying it if you have a lower version or anything. And then for the Warlocks, he has the Obsidian Mind, which I am going to be buying because, as you can see, my Obsidian Mind is lower stats, and this is pretty significant. So I'm going to be buying that as well. So this week I'm spending strange coins. Now for the gun, I already said this, he has the Mito multi-tool. Great weapon if you'd like to just run around a lot. Great weapon for Hunters for the first part of the Abyss. I have one, it's pretty fun. It's fun just running that fast overall. It's not a go-to weapon, you don't really need it, but you know, it's fun. And of course he has the Exotic Shard. And this week's Exotic Engram is the Gauntlet. Alright, now for upgrade equipped exotics, the Symbiote, as I stated before, for the Hunters, the Crest of Alpha Loopy for the Hunters, which I will also be upgrading this week because that is a high stat roll. The Armamentarium for the Titans, that's a chest piece, I will also be upgrading that because that is a higher stat roll than mine. The No Backup Plan Gauntlets for the Titans, that is a... I don't know what... I want to say that's medium. I think they can go higher, but that could also be the highest. I do not know about gauntlets. I don't use these. I still haven't upgraded my old version that caps out at light level 30. So that tells you how much I actually use these now, how important this is to upgrade. Now for the Warlocks, he has a Skull, which is intellect out of 93 out of 99, excuse me. Mine is a 101. Great helmet for PvP. I used it a lot for PvP. Tougher while using Nova Bombs instead of Obsidian Mine because I feel like I don't need Obsidian Mine for PvP. More of this. Like, I used it a lot. I used Skull during Iron Banner a lot, and I really liked it. And then, of course, he has the Apotheosis Veil, which is 116 out of 125. Now mine is 124, and I will not be upgrading it for that one extra discipline because it's not worth it in my opinion, and I don't think you guys should either. great stuff for this week, I would say. Like, the upgrade-wise, at least in my opinion. That's just because I need them. Now, I don't use the Crest of Alfalupi for the Hunters. Let me return this real quick. I don't use it, but that's a really high stat roll that I want. So, I'm going to do it. Now, for the upgrade equipment, Exotics, he has the Bad Juju, the Last Word, the Thorn, the Invective, the Pocket Infinity, and the Thunderlord. I recently started using the Bad Juju. Great weapon. Honestly, I don't know why I didn't like it before. Great weapon. Last Word, amazing in PvP. I use that gun a lot. Thorn, amazing in PvP, but I don't use it just because I feel it's a little bit cheap, but that's just me. That's Invective, don't use it. I know it's a great shotgun, though. Pocket Infinity, never used it, so I couldn't really tell you. Thunderlord, great PvE weapon and PvP, but you don't shoot it that much to actually get full use of the weapon, of the actual lightning round perk. For my selection of what to upgrade first, if you have the old weapons, I would say if you play PvP, Last Word then first, and then PvE would be Thunderlord. All these other weapons, you can get them from bounties. Now down here, he has a pulse rifle telemetry, the hand cannon telemetry, fusion rifle telemetry, plasma drive, emerald coil, and heavy ammo. Now I think I'm running low on heavy ammo. Let's check. Okay, well, maybe not so much, but I will probably be buying heavy ammo. But that is it for this week. I hope you guys enjoyed, and have a good day.